Bolt actions speak louder than words.
So if the first shot doesn't get them, the second and third one will.
For all you eagle-eyed sharpshooters out there, today we're discussing the crossbow expert feat in Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition.
Greetings, adventurers. My name is Monty Martin.
And I'm Kelly McLaughlin.
And we are the Dungeon Dudes.
Today we're taking an in-depth look at the crossbow expert feat in D&D 5e.
Yeah, we're going to look at some of the character build options, including classes, other feats, abilities, and equipment that will help you create the ultimate range damage dealer in Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition.
We're also going to clarify some of the rules and strategies involved in the crossbow expert combination.
And we're going to brainstorm some role-playing ideas to help you connect your character's battlefield tactics to their personality and outlook.
So, let's lock and load. There's a lot of different rules to this feat, so why don't we start by going over the official text here.
Yeah, as always, with any feat, it's something that you can select instead of taking an ability score increase when your character reaches an appropriate level in your class. With the crossbow expert feat specifically, there's three main benefits. The first of which is that you ignore the loading property of any crossbow with which you are proficient. We're going to talk about what this means in just a moment.
The second one is that if you are within 5 feet of a hostile creature, it no longer imposes disadvantage on your crossbow attacks.
The final benefit is that if you take the attack action on your turn and use a one-handed weapon to attack, you can then spend a bonus action to make an additional attack with a hand crossbow that you're already wielding.
So all three of those work in pretty different ways.
Yeah, but they turn out that they synergize really, really well. But in a way that's a little bit counterintuitive to what you might think at first.
So let's go through each one and just describe it in a little more detail.
Yeah. So the first thing is that you ignore the loading property of a hand crossbow with which you're proficient. What does this actually mean? Well, let's take a look at the loading property of a crossbow first. So the loading property states that because of the amount of time required to put a piece of ammunition into a weapon, you can only make one attack with it whenever you take an action, bonus action, or reaction to attack with this weapon. When you have the crossbow expert feat, you ignore this restriction.
So that means that if you have the extra attack feature, you don't get to reap the benefits of that if you don't have the crossbow expert feat.
Precisely. And the crossbow expert feat, in turn, means that you can benefit from extra attack when you're using a crossbow. There's a really small corner case as well that if you are a ranger with the Swift Quiver spell using a bonus action to attack twice, you'd actually need the crossbow expert feat to use Swift Quiver as well.
So a lot of classes can actually really benefit from this, and it actually feels like it almost completes those classes by having this feat.
As long as you want to use a crossbow. Because technically speaking, if you didn't have crossbow expert and you were somehow able to attack with your bonus action, say, for instance, someone's cast the haste spell on you, you can still attack with your action with a crossbow and then attack with a bonus action. It's just that you can't attack more than once in one of those individual actions unless you have the crossbow expert feat. What this builds towards, though, is that crossbows have the ammunition property. And there's a really important thing that you don't ignore with this, is that when you're using ammunition, you still need to have a hand free to load the weapon, right?
Yeah.
Even if it's one-handed. So, one-handed or two-handed. So what this means then is, if you're using a hand crossbow and you've got the crossbow expert feat, you still have to have an empty hand to load that hand crossbow.
This kind of ruins the character idea of the guy with the hand crossbow and the rapier who gets to like stab and shoot.
Yeah, because one of the things that 5th edition doesn't have that prior editions of D&D did have is rules that state that you can preload a crossbow. You actually, there's nothing in the rules of D&D, 5th edition, that says crossbows can be loaded with an action. They're automatically loaded whenever you go to attack with them, right? So you would actually need some sort of house rule if you wanted to say that a character could carry several loaded crossbows at once, because there's no action required to actually load a crossbow. It's done when you make the attack.
But you still need that free hand.
Yes.
So one of the simplest parts of this feat is that you get to stand within 5 feet of an enemy creature and still fire your crossbow at them without having disadvantage.
Yeah, this is super awesome because it really negates one of those downsides of ranged combat that when an enemy runs up to engage with you in melee, you have disadvantage on all your attacks suddenly. So the crossbow expert doesn't have to worry about any of this whatsoever. They can still fire willy-nilly right when an enemy's standing right in front of them.
Yeah, so the crossbow expert doesn't have to be super afraid of getting into that close combat. I mean, you still want to avoid it if you're a ranged combatant, but when you get into that situation, it's much easier to take on. What about the third option there?
This is the really controversial part of Crossbow Expert.
Yeah.
Because this one concerns attacking with a bonus action. And when people look at it the first time, it's a little bit confusing. Because it says that when you attack with a one-handed weapon, you can then use a bonus action to attack with a hand crossbow that you're already holding. There's a few technical problems with this, because I think the first image that comes into many people's minds is that of the rapier and crossbow combination.
Yeah, which still doesn't work exactly the way you imagine it's
going. No, it doesn't, because if you're holding a rapier in one hand, you don't have a hand free to load the crossbow in your other. As we said earlier, there's nothing in the rules that allows you to preload a crossbow in Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition. You only load the weapon when you actually go to attack with it. So unless you're going to house rule and say that you can preload a crossbow, it actually breaks the crossbow expert feat. Doesn't work. What does work, however, is the fact that a hand crossbow in itself is already a one-handed weapon. And the feat doesn't specify that you have to be holding a weapon in your offhand or that you can't use the weapon that you attacked with to attack again with your bonus action.
So this means that by attacking with the hand crossbow, you fulfilled the requirements to then use your bonus action to attack again with that hand crossbow.
Exactly. And this is, in fact, with the way the rules are set up in 5th edition, the only way this functions. You must be using a hand crossbow. It must be the only weapon you are wielding. You must have a free hand. And you must use your attack action on your turn to attack with that weapon. And then you can use the bonus action to attack with the same weapon.
That may sound like it takes away from it, but honestly, I think it's pretty cool to be able to pull out a hand crossbow and be like, psh, psh,
psh.
I don't know if that's how you shoot a crossbow.
It's not, but many people get the image of that desperado gunslinger pulling the hammer on a pistol.
Yeah.
And so that kind of has sunk into the consciousness, I think, of the crossbow expert feat, and results in something that's actually pretty cool and deals a lot of damage. So again, this is actually the only way that it works, and it's been clarified both in the FAQ and by Jeremy Crawford on Sage Advice several times that this is indeed the way the crossbow expert feat is meant to work.
All in all, this kind of makes crossbow expert the distant cousin of polearm master, but for ranged attacks.
Yeah, and it's interesting because it kind of locks you into using a specific type of weapon, in this case, only a hand crossbow. But it then kind of feels like it sets you up with some disadvantages. A hand crossbow has a very paltry range and a pretty feeble 1d6 damage die. But there might be something that we can actually do to make that a lot better.
It pairs very, very well with another one of our favorite feats for ranged attacks.
Sharpshooter.
Yeah. So the combination of those two feats together can really amp up your ranged game.
Let's look at why.
So the first part of the sharpshooter feat is that it actually gets to ignore half cover and three quarters cover when you're using a ranged attack.
And you also ignore the penalty for attacking at long range using a ranged weapon you're proficient with.
And one of the best parts of it, if you take a -5 penalty to your hit, you get to add a +10 to your damage, which can be really powerful.
So all of these combined together with Crossbow Expert, like cheese and wine.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first thing I think that's really important to note is that a crossbow has a very pathetic range. 30 feet is its normal range with up to 120 feet as its long range. So sharpshooter right away negates the really bad range of a hand crossbow.
Yeah, you now instantly have 120 feet without needing to roll with disadvantage.
Combined with the fact that you ignore half cover and three quarters cover mean that your enemies can't hide from you. They can't go to your longer range to give you disadvantage. And now they also can't engage in melee with you to give you disadvantage.
On top of that, with the minus 5 plus 10, a lot of people see that and get a little worried, like, oh man, minus 5 to my roll to hit, I might hit less. But you might hit less, but you're going to hit so much harder when you do.
And the fact that Crossbow Expert is giving you a third attack means that you're kind of gambling on two of the three landing. Again, you're probably going to be using this with a class that has the extra attack class feature. So at the very least, you're going to be making three attacks per round as long as you use your action and bonus action. You take the penalty on all of those. Very much, you're looking at anywhere from 30 to 40 damage if all of them land, and a huge hit even if one of them lands.
Yeah, so it's a very powerful combination.
And there's quite a few classes that really take this into overdrive. Let's look at some of them now and think about where we would want to pair these feats in terms of the class that we choose.
So let's talk about one of the best choices, the fighter class.
You can't go wrong with this one. Right from the beginning, the fighter comes online the fastest because you gain that additional feat at 6th level. So you can take Crossbow Expert at 4th and Sharpshooter at 6th, or play a human and come online even earlier.
I was going to say Variant Human can help out with this.
So you've got the combination going right from the beginning. The other thing that's great is that because the fighter gets the archery fighting style, which gives you a plus 2 bonus to hit, it offsets the penalty from Sharpshooter.
Yeah, you're now gambling less on those shots and much more likely to hit even more.
Yeah, what archetype do you think you would take with this as the fighter?
I mean, Champion might be a good one just because you get to crit a whole bunch more. And if you're a ranged fighter, you might not have as many options for the battle maneuvers. But there are still a few that are pretty good in there.
One of the really cool things is that you can still knock someone prone with a ranged attack with a Battlemaster maneuver. I like to imagine that as kneecapping somebody.
Oh, wow.
And because you don't have disadvantage when they're within 5 feet of you, you can run up to somebody, shoot them in the thigh, knock them prone, and now keep shooting them. Because you've negated the disadvantage from being within 5 feet of somebody, you now have the advantage that they're prone and you're within 5 feet of them.
Wow.
So you're basically knocking them over and shooting them in the back while they're on the ground.
You know, that guy used to be an adventurer, but then he took an arrow to the knee.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. I think the other awesome thing, just straight up, is the fact that Action Surge is the thing.
Yeah.
And right off the top, if you want to see amazing Novas, the ranged fighter using Action Surge and making 5 ranged attacks, I've seen that blow up a beholder in the first round of combat with a couple good critical hits and extra damage. It's really, really hard to avoid.
I'm going
to
name this character John Wick.
Pretty much. The Ranger is also similarly fantastic for many of the same reasons.
Yeah, I have a Ranger playing at my table right now who uses this combination and is pretty unstoppable.
Yeah, it's really good, especially with things like the Hunter archetype where you get Colossus Slayer, or the Gloomstalker where you just straight up get that additional attack.
Yeah.
The Gloomstalker's 11th level feature where they get to reroll a missed attack is really good too, because you're going to have that attack penalty. So you're probably going to miss one of those attacks, and getting an additional attack because you missed really balances that all out. Like the fighter, you also have the archery fighting style. The one problem with the Ranger is that you have Hunter's Mark.
Yeah.
And getting Hunter's Mark going with your bonus action is competing with just making a straight up attack.
Yeah, I actually think that eventually the Ranger at my table got rid of Hunter's Mark as one of her.
Yeah, I think that what you want to start looking at are spells like Flame Arrows or Conjure Animals, which you can cast before combat, instead of having to worry about getting your Hunter's Mark out there, because eventually by high levels as a Ranger, if you're using this combination, you're always going to want to use your bonus action for making more attacks, and you're going to be doing so much damage that the target that you Hunter's Mark is going to die, and then reapplying the Hunter's Mark is going to be more effort than it's worth.
Great, so let's talk about some of the awesome role-playing ideas that we can use to inspire our crossbow expert.
I think we kind of touched on this when we were talking about the feat itself, but the Wild West style pistolier is super cool to inform this one.
Yeah.
So much so that I could even see just reflavoring the hand crossbow as being a pistol, as a kind of backdoor way into having a gunslinger in a campaign. If you don't want to use like one of the custom gunslinger classes, but you're okay with reflavoring hand crossbows to being pistols, it's such a cool image and it works really well.
And the person at my table who plays the ranger with the crossbow expert, she always, whenever she gets up, is describing the hammering action. And even though that doesn't work with the crossbow, I just think it's such a cool image of her being there like... Psh,
psh, yeah, psh. I've had players do that too. And I think that they're kind of riffing on the fact that you still have to pull back the string and set it.
Yeah.
And it just is cool to imagine a character that is so quick on the draw, right? And also really in your face. Like, the crossbow expert feels much shorter range compared to someone that's using a longbow, who's more of a sniper. Whereas the crossbow expert is more of a duelist, right? In a lot of ways. And so I think that you can really imagine, like, I can also imagine, like, the gentleman dueler, right? Someone that's very respectful and kind of bows or says, you've insulted my honor and now we're going to like take 10 paces and I'm going to shoot you in the back three times.
Well, another one that I mentioned a little earlier was John Wick and the image, because before I saw John Wick, I'd never seen somebody use a gun the way that he does.
It's kind of absurd. That movie,
But it's almost like a close combat gunfight.
Yeah.
And if you have all those attacks and you can attack within 5 feet of your enemy, you can just run up and pull a John Wick and just be like, bam, 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 bam.
You know, as awesome as John Wick was, I think Keanu Reeves' earlier movies, like The Matrix, kind of more defined gun-fu. And so you could also kind of just find any Keanu Reeves action movie and find some pretty awesome ranged weapon play that I think, if you want to kind of take it into a little bit of a fantastical realm, you can really inform that one-handed pistol sort of image on any sort of crossbow thing.
So are we now saying that the crossbow expert is the Keanu Reeves feat?
Pretty much.
Cool.
Yeah.
So for you DMs out there, there's a few things to keep in mind if one of the players at your table has crossbow expert, especially if they have crossbow expert and sharpshooter.
Now, we both dealt with one in our recent campaigns, and we both had it pretty bad.
Yeah. I have a bad habit of not realizing how much damage this has the potential to do. And big bad guys are getting one shot in the first round.
And spoiler warnings, there's a hardcover adventure module that bestows a special power on one of the player characters where they get an extra attack as well. And in my experience writing this hardcover module, the crossbow expert sharpshooter got this ability.
Oh no.
So they were attacking like five times a turn. It's a lot of damage, primarily because the combinations with the fighter and the ranger have so much upfront damage. It's like a tactical laser coming down from orbit and vaporizing the most dangerous enemy on the field, because it can come from as far away as 120 feet. And for most dungeon-style combats and most encounters in general that are combat-based, you're not usually working with ranges longer than that, right? So there's nowhere to hide unless that enemy is behind total cover.
Yeah, and just to give you some perspective, most of the players at my table are averaging between, I'd say, like 30 to 60 damage in their round. On occasion, I've seen the crossbow expert pull out over 100.
Yep.
And I'm just baffled by that.
And there's so few ways to protect your important monsters. Even flying creatures don't generally get attacks with ranges longer than 100 feet. Like, if you look at most dragons, up until the very highest challenge ratings, their breath weapons actually don't have a range longer than 30 to 60 feet. So they still have to come down into the threat range of the crossbow expert in order to attack and fight back.
What's the solution then? If you're a DM, what do you try to do to kind of make it more balanced?
So the first thing I think that's really important to keep in mind is that whenever you have a player that's using a powerful strategy like Crossbow Expert, you need to acknowledge the fact that that player gets a lot of enjoyment out of executing that strategy. And so if every single encounter that you throw in front of them, you're finding some way to play against it, they're going to get really frustrated and feel like they're unfairly targeted. So I do think it's important that when you do have a high potential damage dealer, have one throwaway combat encounter where they just get to feel awesome. That's okay, right?
Yeah.
But then when you do want to challenge them, there's a few key things that you can do. The first of those is nothing in any of these feats let them ignore the weather.
Ah, so change the weather on them.
Change the weather. If you look at some of the weather rules in the Dungeon Master's Guide, even a moderate rainfall imposes disadvantage on ranged attacks. Right?
I'm already getting ideas.
Yes. Yeah. So there you go. And if you want to have a big windstorm, it makes ranged attacks impossible. Since they have a good dexterity score, they probably are carrying a backup finesse weapon, and they'll be okay. Right? Now, that's a pretty hard lock. If you want to create more interesting combat scenarios, I recommend using spells that have enemies that have spells like Fog Cloud and Wind Wall. These are going to be spells that will block ranged attacks within a certain area of the battlefield. And then if you combine that with creatures that have blindsight, they still get to fight effectively. Oftentimes, if the Gloomstalker, they'll have dark vision, but sometimes the Crossbow Expert is just a human.
Yeah.
Because they front-loaded it. And then they don't have dark vision.
So turn the lights off on
them. Turn the lights off on them, too. Right? Any way that you can't hide behind cover, but you can hide in darkness, and you can hide in fog, and you can hide in bad weather. And interestingly enough, all the things like changing the weather and using darkness and light in interesting ways and using that terrain in interesting ways are just going to make a more interesting combat encounter in general. So the whole party's going to have an interesting obstacle to contend with. And the sharpshooter crossbow expert might not even notice that they're the one that is the reason why.
The battles that I always remember the most are the ones that have interesting things going on, like extreme weather. So that's just gonna make it memorable and awesome.
Yeah. I think the other point of advice is that it's rather conspicuous that the Dungeon Master's Guide doesn't have any special magical crossbows. and so one of the possible counterplays is instead of awarding a magic weapon to your crossbow expert, give out lots of magical ammunition. Finally, I think this is a mistake that both of us have made, but be very careful about putting a magic item that lets your crossbow expert sharpshooter fly.
Yeah, please. one of the biggest lessons I've ever learned as a dungeon master was I gave my crossbow expert ranger flying boots.
At very low levels.
At a much lower level than I should have, and it's been an interesting campaign. Yeah.
I think the biggest thing with any player that is using a power combination, it's not like you don't want to withhold the nice toys from them.
Yeah.
But you want to very carefully gauge how much it's going to make a difference for them. A big mistake is homebrewing a crossbow version of the Oathbow. That is a very big mistake.
Yeah.
To put in the hands of a sharpshooter crossbow expert. Because then it's all downhill from there, and your villain will never survive the first round of combat ever again.
So this has been our in-depth guide to the Crossbow Expert feat in Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. We hope that you feel inspired to slay a whole bunch of monsters with your crossbow.
And we'd love to hear in the comments below any thoughts or ideas that you might have on strategies for using crossbows or working against a very powerful range damage dealer as a DM.
And if you want to check out a guide to a different feat, we have the Polar Master right up over here.
And if you also need more on the Fighter and the Ranger, we've got our playlist on class guides right up over here.
Please subscribe to our channel so that you never miss an episode.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time
in the dungeon.